Okay, well.
I want to live in a world where my grandchildren can look back on climate change and say, wow, that was a close one. But with the way things look right now, that's not going to happen. I'm missing several classes to be here right now, and having to make up schoolwork is a pain, so missing school is not something I enjoy. Education, both my own and that of others, is very high on my list of priorities, but the world has come to the point where climate change is more important. Is tearing the only planet we have into pieces that we can't hope to repair. This is one of the reasons why we're here today, to disrupt our daily routine and bring attention to the fact that climate change is here, whether we like it or not, and it's not going to go away all by itself. That's our job. I have heard people say many, many times that the youth of today will be the saviors of the world, that my generation will be the ones to slow climate change to a stop. However, the world can't wait for all of us to be able to vote or drive or have our own credit cards. This is a movement that needs everyone. No matter how old you are, no matter how many climate rallies you haven't been to, no matter how many hours a week you work, we need every single person. Small, medium, and large things you can do are important. What you do counts, and how you do it matters. We are all very literally in this together. Sometimes we have so much on our minds that it's hard to form coherent thoughts. Our heads are so stuffed full of worry that we can't find the words to describe it. But we can use actions. Walking out of school, leaving work, organizing a rally, these are actions that build and build into a barrier so high that the corporations can no longer scale it with their money and blatant lies. As a community, as one human race, we are capable of making all the right decisions before the Earth, as we know it, dies off the cliff that it's barreling towards. We are all perfectly capable of digging in our heels and refusing to let the worst of us get the better of us. The thing about climate change is that it is not really a battle between good and evil. There may not be any clear winner, but this battle is one that we must fight. We must fight for our dignity and the dignity of the soil that sustains us and the dignity of our neighbors, all of our neighbors. Whether we win or lose or end up somewhere in between, this battle is one that must be struggled through because it is a battle for the dignity of the earth and everything on it. And if we don't have that, what do we have left?